Hi, my beautiful family. So you all know I've introduced the new Decoat. The new Decoat is the Petticoat's new version. I mean, it's the 20th century, guys, and I think we need to upgrade ourselves. From Petticoat, we upgrade ourselves to the new Decoat. Now, what is the speciality of Decoats? Decoat is made of cotton fabric. Being cotton, it still has its stretch. Now, I need to share with you a few things which I've seen it online, and I personally, it's my personal feeling that you might not feel very comfortable. I mean, if you're feeling comfortable, please go ahead. It's just the personal feeling. And over the years, like it's been more than a decade when I've been doing draping, I have seen that these things have created some or the other problems, like something what she's wearing today. It's like too body hugging. I mean, it is fine if you just have to stand and do nothing, walk 4 steps front, 4 steps back. I mean, I understand. But what if you need to bend down, sit in the car, sit on a sofa? I mean, it is so tight from this part. If it is not a stretch, you might have, you know, the stitches might open from this side. You'll feel very uncomfortable. And what if you have to bend down and you come up, the entire fabric will get gathered here. And more than anything, how are you going to justify if you put on like an inch or two? Will you throw this? So these are the problems, and the solution is one and only one, the new Decoat. Now what you need to do is, I would not advise you to wear something which is so body hugging, because for me, no matter what, but comfort comes first. So that's the reason every step that I've taken, from the fabric to the drawstring to the extender to the cut, I think what I've kept in my mind is your comfort. So this is a size small, which is what, you know, the way she's worn, this is how it looks. But this is a size medium, fits her very well, gives you the shape you want, not too tight, making you feel very comfortable to do your day-to-day activities. I think that is what is my motto, to spread this beautiful Indian art of draping to every single corner of this world, to make you understand that this is like the most beautiful and the most comfortable garment that we have. So guys, I would really not advise you to wear something which is so tight, so body hugging. Try and wear something which is more comfortable, and I think try and wear a new Decoat. That is what is my message to you. So let me show you. It's not that you can't drape a sari on it. I'm going to show you how you can drape a sari on this, but I think a size bigger would always be more advisable. Now she's wearing this, and she's not a person who would want to wear the Decoat so high. I mean, she always feels, you know, on the navel or right just below the navel is what she is more comfortable. But her Decoat has its shape. But we have a special feature here, which is the Decoat extender, which is this. So if you don't want to use this, and what is the special feature is, we've given you 2 drawstrings. It's here. Okay, let me show you in this. You'll be able to see this better. Here. So this is 1 drawstring because we don't have an extender here. I hope you can see this very clearly. Okay. And this is 2 drawstring because we have an extender here. Now, since she wants to keep it on her navel, or a little below her navel, I would advise her to just fold this. Everything just goes inside, and I'm just going to give it 1 fold this way, and it rests on her navel where she is most comfortable or where she is more used to wearing it. So let me show you how you can drape a sari, a beautiful organza sari in an open palla style. So let me have the sari. Yay! So this is an organza sari which I'm going to drape on this. So let me start, but before I start, guys, we all know that our average height is 5'3". So if you don't wear something this body hugging, it'll be good for you because you'll have enough, you know, space for you to tuck in the fabric. If your underskirt, if your decot is, you know, not decot, decot you'll have no problem. But if your petticoat is very tight, where will you insert the fabric? You need to understand that. That's the reason comfort comes first. So here I'm going to tuck in this 2 inches from our navel. We'll just start tucking in this. And take this fabric from behind and keep tucking it. Because of the thin elastic which is given over here, the sari really holds very well. And the drawstring, the drawstring is specially weaved. It is very, very thin, doesn't give you any extra bulge here, which the normal drawstring which is available in the market or the petticoat which is available in the market does give. Okay, after you've done this, just take this fabric from here and tuck this here. And what I'm doing is I'm giving you this drape, which is an open palla, a free flow palla, or a khulla palla, which is called in Hindi. So we'll just do this and we'll do rough pleating. This is how I do. And you'll take this a little below your knee. Use a peg and just to hold the pleats, that's it. From here, cover your bust, bring the entire sari here and tuck this. Okay, so yeah, so far everything is clear. Now in open palla, what is the major problem? When you put the palla on your shoulder, this side of the fabric or the fabric which is there in your arms becomes too long and it starts floating and you don't know how to manage because it's become very long. So this problem is majorly I've seen in a lot of people when they wear this open palla. So let me show you how you can solve that. So you just tuck this fabric here. Okay, after you've done that, just drop this whole thing down. Okay, after you've done that, just tuck it properly so that, you know, it just doesn't move away, and start making your lower pleats. See, this is how I make my lower pleats. I'm just going to make my lower pleats. Yeah, so this is how I get my lower pleats all done. I'm just going to dust it. Got all the pleats in place. Now hold all of them together, align them, and right below your navel, you're going to take this and tuck this. And hold this entire pleat from here also and tuck this also inside. Okay? And you can just use a hair straightener to iron these pleats. Look at this. Like this. Got it? Okay. Now what you need to do is this part of the fabric, just tuck this part here and from this hand, give this fabric to this hand. Like this. See, can you see this? I can pull this. I can. Yeah. So after you've done that, just tuck this part here. And if you cannot tuck in, you can just take one pin I mean, if you cannot tuck in, because sometimes the sari is short or sometimes the length of your height is longer, so then you can just take a pin and attach a pin here. Like what I'm doing right now. And after that, just take the entire sari and tuck the whole thing inside. Like this. After you've done this, what you need to do is just take this fabric from here, remove the peg, rest this on your bust properly and on your shoulders. And if you have a beautiful embroidered blouse like this, I mean, why do you want to cover the whole blouse? You can always take it a little low and then just add a pin here. A pin on the shoulders like this. Now see, what I was mentioning is this part. See, this is this length and this is also this length after you've done this here. Look at this. So it's not flowing, it's not trailing down, it's just the right way you want it. So since it's an organza fabric, don't go for making narrow pleats to rest it on your arms. Just take one broad pleat and another to, and like this, rest it on your arms like this, and look at this. Looks really very graceful. If you think you cannot handle this, take another pin. Attach the whole pin here. You can use a small golden pin which is not visible. Just attach it here. Insert this inside, hold it like this. This makes it so easy for you to handle any sari which has thick, broad borders, even organzas, even chiffon, even georgettes, crepe, net, any kind of a fabric. You just need to know the right way to pin, the right amount to pleat, and the right technique can be taught exactly at the platform where you're watching. So I'm just kidding, guys, but you know, you yourself are very good at it. I am just putting in that little extra X factor for you to get that finished look, and I think this is where the finished look comes. To try and drape the way I have given you and try and drape it on the new decote and see the difference, how beautiful you start feeling, not only outside but even within you. So keep enjoying my drapes and keep loving me, and do leave a feedback, because your feedback is the most important thing. So thank you so much, guys, and keep loving me. I love you all.